Dark Wave. Break it down.
Juicy doing a little bit of drive-by. I love that. Did you see how Juicy drove up that hill and did not stop? He drove through the middle and made a U-turn, and then he got shot at. So that's a great way of scouting. I call that the bait and switch, right? You drive up to a compound, but you don't stop, because if you stop, the enemy camping there, they're going to wait for you to run into like one of the rooms or one of the doorways, and then they kill you. So instead, you just continue driving the whole way through, and hopefully that'll panic the enemy player to shoot and give away their position. Now that they know about this position, they're pushing together as a four-man team, and they're going to try and take this spot over from Nova.
Yeah, just the one building. They've identified the player who's here, and it is Skies. And there's so much meta analysis I want to break down with this push. The fact that the player didn't wait to shoot suggests to me that there's only one player there. They're trying to scare them away. They also know that this is an area that Nova likes to drop. Nova likes to split drop. Therefore, Xset can look at this and go, this is probably Nova, and they're probably split. We need to push this. Their vehicle was smoking, and they still took that push. That's how confident they were in that call. This is a fantastic position from Lazarus to try and make this ascent. They can just do it one step at a time.
Yeah, and they need to do these steps perfectly, or else one of them is going to get knocked, and then it slows things down. The other thing they got to remember, it's Sandhawk. If they take this fight too long and they don't kill off Exa at the top, another team is going to come behind them. So this is why they're continuing to push this aggression up top. They know the longer they take, the worse it's going to get for them. And it looks like, if done correctly, oh, beautiful nade by Sixless. Sixless is back in the building. Juicy goes down. It's just all on to Nico now and Lazarus. They are pushing it hard.
They identified how critical the top of this hill was gonna be. They looked into this next circle and said, this is a great spot. Let's take it over for ourselves. And now, Nico, full sprint. Hold down, get out of here. Zute not for long. Beast taking some shots here. Nice little angle, but gets caught out by Chonu. Great peek as Dior Esports are getting ripped apart one after another. Still a good amount of kills for them, but Level X is looking to put the nail in this coffin. The blue is forcing them in one after another, spraying, praying. Level X getting down after down after down. It all comes down to Nesquik in a 1v4. That is going to be it. That's going to be the chicken dinner. Level X take game number one.
Ghost Gaming, they smell a third-party opportunity. Spec moving up, but oh, beautiful nade by Ghost. I don't know if this is good for Ghost or not, because they're kind of sandwiching themselves. But if they're just going to run over Dior, all power to them.
Yeah, I mean, look, they smell blood in the water, which means that, hey, this is an opportunity to get involved. But hey, Xset still looking to come back into the fray, into the scrap. They got the revive off. But like you said, they're on the outside of the circle. The reason Ghost wanted to take this over is because now they get to play gatekeeper to Xset. And Dior, one player out on the outside looking in. Yahir will go and try and survive. And now two of the top teams in the lobby are duking it out. Identical position, almost identical team colors. Ghost Gaming is looking to take it over Xset. Nico is down once again. Ghost will look to get the revive off on their side. It all comes down to the nades. That Molotov just a little bit short.
Yeah, great nade trades right there. One knock each from each team. Now, Bayo, it looks like Ghost is the team that's going to get aggro. Nico goes down, did not get, he was not able to heal. That goes spec down, Bayo's down. 2-for-2 trade, it's a 2v2 situation right now. Tenza go down, 1v2 for HH24. Can HH clutch this up? Killswitch taking shots right now. HH is actually running it back. This is such a good position for this circle, and they're going to take it over by force. King A with the defense, though. Nico jumping out of his, oh no, Nico kind of drove in too fast on his own, and don't make the same mistake. Xset, oh, the second Xset does a good play. They just absolutely throw it now. J7.
Third time's the charm. Third
Let's go, J7.
J7, let's go.
And there we go.
Done. Yeah, they're a team that could potentially come in and third party. This Level X eventually does go down. Carnage, what a peek. Molotov in hand. I don't need guns. I have a glass bottle and fire. And it's actually doing some work. Fameboys is taking a lot of damage. The bank nades off the ceiling comes in, and that's the revenge they were looking for. It all comes down to Xenox in a 1v4 situation. He's done it once. Can he do it again? Back into the corner. Nade is being primed, cooked, signed, sealed, delivered. And he comes in with the Uzi, but he's getting third party from Bishop, flushed out of the corner with the Molotov, takes one down, but gets dropped in return. The third party and the Molotov to flush him out, and now the unnamed on camera and in a great position.
It's a 2v3 situation, about to be a 2v4. STU will be able to get that reset, and this should be the unnamed game. They're on camera, and they're about to get that chicken dinner. This is looking really strong for them.
And it's looking even stronger as Alucard overextends all to throw the nade, which means it all comes down to Chico in the 1v4, and the position's been made. That's the chicken dinner, the unnamed, with a gutsy push into 19 esports and then a slow, steady, methodical run up against the Knights. What a display of smart utility usage.
See Nico trying to throw something. Oh, beats up Chico. Nico and Chico, that rhymes, but I'll tell you what doesn't rhyme, a grenade right in your face. That thing hurts. We'll see if they're going to be able to try to find an off angle here. You can see Nico doing a big rotation, trying to get that revenge for Juicy. Now, this isn't even fight between these two teams. They know who they're facing, and it's all about just that initial knock. That's what's so crucial. Yeah, you do have Alucard that off angle. If he comes and helps out, it'll definitely be a huge advantage. Oh, that nade. There's Alucard showing up with that M4. That's huge. So now X set. Not looking good for them. Not looking good here. It's all up to J7. Can he do it? Oh, he's gotta watch out for that gas can. Oh, he's not gonna be able to do nothing. Yeah, the Knights doing a great job. Oh, Fayboys with the Bob Barker, the MK. Shutting down Ghost. Can he get the last kill? Oh, the Bayo. Oh, Bayo's so lit. One HP behind this rock. Oh, this is the worst thing that could have happened for Ghost. But at Ollie. The end of the day, it's still a top four finish. Will that Molly hit? Could be a little off the mark. Bayo gonna throw. Oh,
it's money.
It's not. Bayo hurt, baby, and Bayo down. Fade boys, still up. Three teams remaining. Who's the last one? Oh, HQA.
AZ. Luzo. Healing since 12 teams. Healing since 12 teams. That's if they got taken out in 12th, that's 1 point. Second place is 12 points, Hot Jukes.
Passion Fruit, congrats on the chicken dinner. It ain't a super weekend, so you ain't gonna get $1,000, but you got some good points here. AZ, HQ, I mean, how many times, Dave, have we talked about the heal strat in Sandhawk of how OP it is? AZ, HQA's been out of every fight. Oh, gets a kill?
What?
Or gets a knock? Oh, yeah, that's it. That's it. All right. Just one for the highlight reel, you know, to make himself feel a little bit better. But second place there for HQA. Four kills as well, so that's going to be really big for their points. Shoot some shots to try to get in this one. Oh, Spring! Got the squad wiper! The N249! Can he shut him down? Here he comes, running up. Slap. So many rounds to this gun. Just pre-fire it like crazy. Why are you even stopping? You have plenty of rounds. There you go. Can he get another one? Not going to be able to. Enigma being able to catch him out. And those are his fans. Those are his fans, Dave.
Can't take him out. Newbie one. It's done.
It's just killer with the Uzi. All those lones up. Poppy can open the door. TPV beacon afterwards. Yes, sir. Trying to get some angles. Ooh. Oh, the pre-fire. Oh, going to steal the kill. Yeah, he does get the point. Steals it away from Sixless. Very smart. 11 kills. 12 goes to FBB and shuts it down all by himself. What a big play there from Poppy. Yo, 12 kills from the Panthers. Oh, if they take out Lazarus here. Oh, man. That is... That's it. That's going to be big. That's all I'm going to say. That's going to help out Poppy. Oh, that pre-fire. Not going to do it. That knock. Here they come. Lazarus has to full send it here. They don't? That's a surprise. Sixless gets in the buggy to try to get some extra peaks there with it. I don't know. I think this is a little bit of a misplay from Lazarus. After that knock, I would have liked to see them just kind of play it highly more aggressive. They know how many people are left. Oh, they're probably worried about that off angle. That's why. Interesting.
They're out here fishing. Yeah, they're still fishing with these grenades, trying to really gather all the intel. Yorkie was picked up and immediately taken down from Sixless.
Oh, and Sixless gets taken down. Legal is still up. See, I think they're trying to go for the thirst because they know they have a ton of kill points here. All Lazarus is on top of the roof, getting pieced up big by. Oh, here goes Poppy, running full sail on this corner. Oh, gonna get shut down. Yeah, and that's the game. That's gonna be it. Lazarus able to hold on there, get a chicken dinner. You can see Telly with the AUG.
Oh,
some shots downrange. And here comes Russell now, clearing up some points. There goes the two piece. Can he get the three? Over the back.
From behind.
Survived.
Revenge.
Survived by the, I mean, by the barely anything. Russell's going to have to go to the blue zone. No, Russell almost made it. But 16 kills? for the Pittsburgh Knights. Alucard for the Knights. I think opting to just go ahead and heal it. Now he comes in. Fates Lippman goes for second one on six list. Not going to get it, though. He's going to get shut down. So there goes the Pittsburgh Knights in fifth place. Four teams remaining. It's still a massive performance from the Knights. Huge kills. Jagger still alive from Ghost. Sneaking behind this rock. Hasn't made a noise since. And now he's going to pop out with the Tommy gun against Tally. But Tally's going to say, no, sir. We're not getting 1v4. Not again. Shut down. Nova. Oh, my goodness. Nova still up. Tally going to try to get this reset off. The nade from Rin. So huge. Oh, you got to be careful behind these rocks because you know the nades are going to come some more. They're coming some more. Oh. That's exactly what's going to happen as Nova with the nade from downtown.
Lazarus, they're playing super confident, and they know, you know, they're all they need is top 16. So six is going for the clips. I would call that just pure play right there. And great nade out of Hisu, though. It's a 3v2 situation. A 2v2. Hisu with another knock. Oh, this player, Hisu from TU, man. We have talked about him, and he is playing out of his mind. Two knocks back to back. And now it's a 1v2 as Bucky gets grenaded.
Yep, peace out there. Takes a lot of damage, though. Rolkis preempting the rotation. Hisu going to be able to get off the first aid, but it's a 1v2, like you mentioned before. Trying to find the angles. Pops up and over, but not a lot of HP to work with. Fate's going to push this. They know they got the Chow. Perfect cover in the 2v1. This is turning into the Erangel we know and love. Lots of teams making into the late game. It's Sleepless! Oh, my goodness. The car spray into the car. All right, that's a triple kill in an instant.
Ooh, Alesky. Flying in that buggy, and he goes just a little bit too far, and he does get knocked. Now it's a 4v2 situation, and that aggression instantly triggered out by Mazexis. They know they have the home field advantage. They're controlling majority of the zone, and they are going aggro.
I love this play from them. They've got one player sitting back, continuing to relay info, and the rest of the squad pushes on in. And just like that, the game is done.
I love this out of the Panthers, and that was a cute with a QBZ silence. That is not a gun that you could easily spray with, and he was full standing. Nope. And that, oh, Pappy just driving straight through, getting the info for his team. Even if he gets shot at, that's just info for them. And that quick flank, he's behind cover. Aeson switches to the Uzi, has not reload. Oh, but he gets him. That is Aeson with the M4, but he's the last one up. And the Panthers, oh, quick clinical wipe.
They have high ground, they have circle, they have numbers. X set, everything has been going their way. They only got two kills. They got to just creep in from the north. They got to play passive and quiet, and Ghost Gaming's let's not delay the inevitable. Let's run straight on in. Let's charge. Kill switch up at the top of the hill from X set. They know this game is all but over. Ghost Gaming pushing on in, still not in the next zone. The blue is ticking them away, and this is just X set. Crossing their T's, dotting their I's, and looking to see the whites of their eyes. They're pushing in danger close into the last remaining players. HH24 is going to go down. That's the chicken dinner.
Now, EFC taking a fight with 19E. We are talking about 19E. They have not had any good games. They're 11 points and 18th place. And EFC is a team that for sure knows this. And they're down to one play. I don't think they picked up a single kill point yet so far for 19E. Oh no, they have 2 points. They picked up 2 points so far, but that's about to be it. That is 2 points done. They pick up 2 points this game.
As they're pushing it, we support Farmers as well. Flawless is going to come back to try and support the team over the ridgeline. It's a 1v2. Can they get the dunk? Shots done. Ivorian is there. Can they find them? No, absolutely not. Dior Esports able to do the work. And in that opening, the power vacuum, the Syndicate player is able to push in, clean up those kills. And now it's a 4v1v1.
Yeah, during all that chaos, issue somehow got to. Oh, he gets all of the unnamed. And hey, it's a 1v4, but Syndicate, man, you have already got 15 kills in Dior. Obviously, he didn't have zone. Pick up that kill, Dior, with the chicken winner dinner.
But let's see, will Ghost Gaming, will they get wiped here from 19E, and will Payne be lucky?
Sam with a beautiful knock. Beautiful knock with that nade. And they are so lit. Tensa's going to go in for the 1v1 against Payne with 1 HP. Can they make a play? HH24 is just looking at a whole bunch of Molotovs. Holding the corner at Tensa with the Tommy gun. Papa Ted, so you know when he's got that, you got to really, really be careful in pain, just holding the wrong corner.
Beers was picked up, trying to boost up, trying to heal up. Sixless in the soft cover of the smokes. Looks like they're trying to make a play. That grenade from Fate onto Fear is going to be knocking them to their knees once again. And here comes the follow-up Molly to inflict some more damage.
Yeah, I think he's going to throw that Molly right at the tip of that rock so it could break it and just fall all over and spread out there. It's a tough one to throw, though. It's got to be named perfectly. And Spring able to get a beautiful knock on the roll kits. Oh, my goodness. There they go. Spray catching one. So now it is a 1v2. And then you got Killer.
They picked up roll kits, though. They got the pickup on a roll kit. Sixless trying to confirm some of these kills, make sure that the revive is not going to be possible. And Telly needs to be cautious. Telly was holding that angle against Killer, making sure that they can't make it into the zone. Pulling off that one. Hopefully Killer doesn't play some type of spoiler out there from the blue.
Yeah, beautiful off angle there from Telly, just playing it real smart. At this point, Lazarus, they have everybody up. So I think right now Killer is just literally going for placement, spamming that first play, that first day. Little does he know, he's already secured the highest place that he's going to get. Second place, because this one is all on Lazarus. Northern, hey, the island, baby. You land there, zone goes there, feels good. Oh, okay, Telly.
Confirm it.
Confirms the point. Can he? He doesn't. Oh. He doesn't get it.
Did he?
He doesn't get it. Oh, man. There it is. Yeah, here's the fight that we've all been waiting for here. You can see HQA trying to throw some nades down on the way onto them. Look, we see Pro Era. Oh, Xenox nading Sam? Add nade? Oh, that's devastating. And there goes Carnage down. HQA about to take out 19E. As it's just Acer. Yeah, he's on the run in that dossier. Goodbye, squad. He doesn't need an insane amount of points, really, to move up. That's, of course, if we support Farmers and Aphelion don't perform here, but they're still up and alive. Syndicate still trying to stay up here. Four teams remaining. And you can see Ox have a beautiful angle here onto Aphelion. Gets one. That is so devastating for him. King A trying to go for the res. Gets shut down. Ooh. So that's a big break, a huge break there for Aphelion. Three teams remaining, having the possibility of eliminating one of these teams' dreams, Dave, right here, right now.
We support Farmers just saved the day for Aphelion. They took out that member who was pushing across the open terrain from Syndicate. So that was actually a huge play. That's going to allow Aphelion to get the pickup. Oh, but they were eliminated.
What?
Whoa, King A was spotted.
It was spotted, and now HQA is going to take out We Support Farmers here. I don't know who's going to win this. It's anyone's game. Grave trying to make some plays, not going to be able to do it as HQA used that position, played it perfectly, and get that final chicken dinner. Break it down.